Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Wa la'udwana illa ala al-zalimeen. Wa la'aqibatu lil-muttaqeen. Allahumma salli wa sallam wa barak ala abdika wa rasulika Muhammadin sallallahu alayhi wa sallam wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam tasliman kathira. So just a quick note, inshallah, about tomorrow. Tomorrow, inshallah, we'll be taking a break from the nightly reflection, and instead I'll be doing a full-blown webinar on the virtues of the forgotten month of Sha'ban. And if Sha'ban as a whole is a forgotten month, then coronavirus Sha'ban is super forgotten, since everyone's already talking about what's going to happen with Ramadan. So tomorrow, inshallah, I'll post the link in the comments as soon as I finish the live stream. In fact, I'll probably edit it into the status. Please do join us tomorrow night, inshallah, at the link and register. It's actually at the status, I believe the last status I posted before the live stream. So again, tomorrow night we'll be talking about the virtues of Sha'ban, inshallah ta'ala, in particular when it's extremely forgotten with everything that's going on. Now, tonight I want to actually recap something I'd mentioned today in some detail at the Al-Maghrib Institute webinar. So Al-Maghrib Institute, mashallah, has been having an ongoing class daily, and today I was presenting and I talked a lot about this particular story, so I want to talk about it briefly but from a different angle, inshallah ta'ala, while still, you know, recapping the main point. The greatest tragedy to ever strike this ummah was the death of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. If there was ever a time when the ummah was at risk of losing its clarity, of losing its purpose, of losing its mission, of being entirely paralyzed, it was when the Prophet ﷺ passed away. Think about how heartbroken we are when we see the images of the masjid of the Prophet ﷺ empty. And then think about the companions of the Prophet ﷺ seeing the masjid of the Prophet ﷺ missing the Prophet ﷺ as the imam and his presence, alayhi salatu wasalam. And think about how debilitating that would have been. So nothing had the potential to paralyze like the death of the Prophet ﷺ. It is the greatest tragedy by consensus. The Prophet ﷺ said, at any time you go through a hardship, اذكر مصابك في موت رسول الله. Remember your hardship, remember your tragedy in the death of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And that would put in perspective your own tragedy. And I talked about Abdullah ibn Abbas radiallahu anhuma. Abdullah ibn Abbas radiallahu anhuma was 13 years old when the Prophet ﷺ passed away. And this is a young man that spent every possible moment he could with the Prophet ﷺ. And we know that it was extremely heartbreaking for the companions that had witnessed such a close relationship with the Prophet ﷺ to think about what it would be like to now live in Medina without him. The very famous story of Bilal radiallahu anhu, Bilal, who could not give adhan in Medina anymore, who broke down at Ashhadu Anna Muhammadan Rasulullah and ultimately had to leave Medina because everywhere he looked, he thought of the Prophet ﷺ. So as he's giving the adhan, Ashhadu Anna Muhammadan Rasulullah, he says the name of Muhammad ﷺ and he breaks down. He looks around Medina and he sees Muhammad ﷺ wherever he is. And he had to leave Medina. Abdullah ibn Abbas radiallahu anhuma was the cousin of the Prophet ﷺ and was the nephew of Maymuna, the wife of the Prophet ﷺ. And he literally slept in the bed of Maymuna and the Prophet ﷺ at their feet. One of the famous hadith about the Qiyam, the night prayer of the Prophet ﷺ, was Abdullah ibn Abbas radiallahu anhuma sleeping at their feet as a child and watching the Prophet ﷺ wake up and pray. Abdullah ibn Abbas used to fetch his wudu for him. He used to go and prepare the wudu for the Prophet ﷺ. He accompanied the Prophet ﷺ on journeys, sitting behind the Prophet ﷺ on his riding animal. So he's close to the Prophet ﷺ. He's someone that the Prophet ﷺ literally embraced, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, hugged and made dua for multiple times. I mean, what would it be like to be hugged by the Prophet ﷺ and to have him make dua for you? May Allah allow us that opportunity in the hereafter. Allahumma ameen. And so that's a special relationship. When the Prophet ﷺ passed away, Abdullah ibn Abbas radiallahu anhuma, as a child, and child physically, right? But definitely not spiritually or mentally or emotionally. He could have buckled like everyone else. He could have allowed that trauma to consume him. But instead he said that there is an opportunity here that no one else is availing themselves of. And that is that all of the companions of the Prophet ﷺ are back in Medina now. They're all around the masjid now. Everyone has come back to pray janazah on the Prophet ﷺ, to spend time in the city now. Those that went out and those that lived far away from the city. And he said, this is an opportunity for me to go to all of their doorsteps now and to collect knowledge, to ask them about the things that I missed out on because of my age or because of my absence from the mission of the Prophet ﷺ for the first 20 years of it. Abdullah ibn Abbas was only 10, 20 years into the mission of Islam, and that's because of his family being separated from the Prophet ﷺ, his father, Al-Abbas, being late in his embrace of Islam, and he used every moment of those 3 years, but he knew he had a lot of catching up to do. So he goes to the houses of the companions, sleeps on their doorsteps, one by one, collects every hadith he possibly can, collects every story he possibly can, every account about the Prophet ﷺ he possibly can. And then he collects that for us to benefit from until today. The point being here is that though he could have just grieved like most people were doing, he saw an opportunity in the midst of the greatest tragedy and said, let me be the one to take advantage of that opportunity. And so what I want us to think about in the midst of this crisis that we're in right now, everyone should be thinking, hey, what's the opportunity that others are not taking advantage of? What is the thing that I can do that others are not doing in the community right now, right? And, you know, there are so many things, and that arena of good deeds is only going to grow because the crisis is going to continue, and unfortunately, more people are going to pass away, and this is going to become more and more difficult for the community. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala lighten the burden for us and heal us of this. But the opportunities are going to be there. So think to yourself, okay, who's not being tended to right now? What's the good deed that's not being done right now? What's something that I can take advantage of in this crisis and do some good that other people are neglecting? And that's the mindset of Abdullah ibn Abbas radiallahu anhu, and that's why he was able to get ahead. We ask Allah to give us that mindset as well. Again, tomorrow night, inshallah ta'ala, I'm going to be doing the virtues of the forgotten month of Sha'ban and the especially forgotten month of coronavirus Sha'ban. So please join me tomorrow, inshallah, at the link that I'll go ahead and I'll throw in the comments right now, inshallah ta'ala. And jazakumullah khairan for tuning in nightly. And I'm making dua for you, and I pray that you make dua for me and my family as well. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.